want to start sort of with a controversial issue here, seeing that we are here at the National Stadium. The lights out here, the floodlights, have been down now since 2021 after the aftermath of Tropical Storm Grace. And I just kind of wanted to get your take on that situation. Again, I know that we've previously spoke mm-hmm. about it, but just to kind of elaborate a little bit about the situation with these floodlights.
Well, personally, I think that a part of so many other issues, it being a little bit or a lot of negligence from the bodies that in charge of these facilities. Mm. It's not only at Truman Budden, but now we're talking all of our sport facilities. I don't think that we had that national pride in bringing our facilities back to full runnings. I think we forget about the importance of having our athletes in good facilities. It's not only good for the body, but it's good for your mental health. That we've seen quite a lot of it in Cayman. It's not only about the lights. The fields are in terrible condition also. Now they need to be changed. The bathrooms, every time we get our cleaners to go on and deal with it after tournaments, they're in very bad shape. They're not taking good care of them. So it's a combination of a little bit of everything. Now, on the other hand, we have not only football that use these facilities,
yep.
but we also have different sports. And unfortunately, I'm going to include myself at some point, we've been a little too neglected and always dependent on government because we haven't tried to get together and say, let's see what we can do. Let's see how we could raise some funds. Let's see how we could support the government in getting the facilities because all of us use it.
Yeah.
So it's a combination of everything.
And you mentioned that neglection there, and I feel like based on some of the things that I've heard, that there is some form of personal roadblocks between the sports minister, Bernie Bush, and the association. And I'm trying to figure out if there's any truth to this rumor, if you will, that there's some sort of personal issue with him and the Football Association that is causing some of these backlogs, i.e. The lights not reaching here.
Well, I'm not sure about that. Personally, me and the minister, we have a friendship. That don't have anything to do with business.
Yeah.
He may have his reason why. Could be budget. Could be that is too many going on. But I don't think that Mr. Bush would take things personal not to benefit this country. Because at the end of the day, if there is anything personal against CIFA, you're not hurting CIFA. You're not going to make CIFA look bad. You're hurting the sports family of the Cayman Islands.
Yeah.
You're hurting our 15-year-old, our 20-year-old, our girls, our boys, the visitors that you have, a lot of them that come to Cayman and walk around and see facilities. And you would be hurting yourself. I don't think the minister wants to put himself in that position. So, could be rumors, could be something true to it. The fact is that I really don't know.
I just want to touch back on the finances. I know that the previous sports minister, Juliano O'Connor Connolly, had reinstated the grant to CIFA, and I believe it was $150,000. Is CIFA not getting that anymore?
Unfortunately, we haven't received $1 since the new administration or the new government. So it is what it is, Seaford. We cannot stop our activities and we cannot continue to cry over this and to talk about this. We have to move on. That is how I was raised. That is how my mother teach me to do things. And as the head of the association, the president of the association, we elaborate on one thing. If it's not happening, we have to go to plan B, plan C, plan D. That I'm very thankful that we have that, that we have put it in place, and that's the reason why we continue to grow.